Yes, ok. Hello guys, let's play Truck Simulator. Today they're having the new event for the rebuilding of Genoa Bridge. It's kind of cool, I guess. The kind of interaction between virtual reality and real reality
Yes, ok. Hello guys,
tends to be
let's
especially
play Truck
interesting.
Simulator. Today they're having the new event for the rebuilding of Genoa Bridge.
Okay, so like I said, I was thinking about this the past few days. It's something I've been looking forward to. The Euro Truck Simulator events are always kind of fun for me. You get the leader prize at the end, no? The feeling of participating in a community, and the fact that it's set in Italy makes it even more interesting for me. So in fact, here you have it. It's meant to represent a group effort for the purpose of substituting the bridge, replacing, I mean, the bridge with the new one in the game as it's happening in real world right now. Let's do it. Let's take part. I'm using Vorpex because, as you might expect, the VR version is going to be updated later, meaning that I will be completely alone. I would be incapable of doing it, I mean, unless choosing this path. Wait a sec. This is not positioned correctly. I want to see the audio. Oh, so that I know that everything is working. And here you have the game. Here you have the game, indeed. But I made it crash because of what I did. Yes, never Alt-Tab out of Truck Simulator when you're using this type of config. I knew it from yesterday. We already did the mistake, but it won't happen again. Restarting. I know it works because I tested it, don't worry. Okay. OVR drop coming back. Selecting monitor 2, as you would, and then start the game. Once again, Euro Truck Simulator. Here you have it. Yes, on your desktop. It doesn't. Yes, in theory it appears on my desktop, but then Vorpex relays it to the VR headset. Okay. Hoping that it doesn't happen again. Yes. Continue. I was already driving from Rome, where I have my garage, to Verona, I think, which is one of the cities where you can start the missions for the deliveries to Genoa, indeed. And this is the idea for the day. Hoping that everything was correctly, but it should, because I played Truck Simulator yesterday with no problems. Or just minor problems, I would say. In fact, this is my location currently, already more than halfway. We won't be playing online this time because the event otherwise wouldn't be possible. And this is also positive because it means I can actually go faster than the speed limit. Wait a sec. Unfortunately, the overlay rests too high. It will cover the interface like this, and when I move it, probably the game will crash. I mean, we can try, hoping that it doesn't. Anyway, this is wrong. It gotta stay lower. No. Yes. But lower. Like this. And maybe it won't crash. Maybe I can believe in miracles. No, eh? second attempt. No, it's annoying. Whenever you Alt-Tab, it crashes. Unfortunately, because I'm using a non-standard solution. Unfortunately, it crashes the other thing too. Okay. New game, new problems. You know the deal. Restarting. It covers completely the game interface. That cannot stand. That cannot be accepted. Okay. Bring it down. Maybe. A bit in between, this is too much, I presume, but also make it more, yes, like so. I hope it works. It should. Go again. Excuse me for the delay. You may test everything as much as you would, but then surprises are right around the corner. This is also streaming, of course. The entire point of doing it live. Okay, now it should work. If it doesn't work, I could shoot myself, I guess. And drive.
Mettiamoci alla prova.
Ok. Yes, I like it. Let's do. Hey, hello guys. So yes, you were there waiting for me to actually manage to start the game, and apparently I just have. Like I was saying, we're playing offline today because of the event. Of course, the event is not possible on the mod server, and also this is better for two reasons. One, we have traffic, and two, we can actually drive above the speed limit, which will make everything more fun, I guess, more interesting, and possibly more dangerous. That's also part of the appeal, I guess. What is even the purpose of driving a truck if you don't drive it like a madman? Case in point. We're going to Verona. This is not yet the event's job. For now, I'm delivering some cars, as you see. And this is all because I was sitting in Rome and I had to reach the northern part of Italy where we'd be getting the materials for the Genoa Bridge. This game's driving is kind of realistic. You gotta be careful. When you do crazy things, as I am now, you actually risk overturning the truck. Ah, but I hear the sound is much better since yesterday, yes. Because this is the new version of the game. I was playing an older version for the purpose of playing on Trackers MP. The horn sucked yesterday. I think the entire sound engine is different. Okay. I got all my mods, so yeah. Now I see why most streamers don't play on Trackers MP, just play the game in single player. After all, this is the way it was meant to be played. How far am I? It's kind of dangerous because I got... it's down there, to the bottom right. Okay, 200 kilometers. Let me pass! No, it was kind of boring to drive slowly yesterday. This is way better. Let's see how fast I can go before destroying my truck in a completely thorough way, I guess. And also you can hold the button now. Yes, that's a big improvement. Sounding the horn is like half of the fun, no? Where are we going now? Another 16. This is too slow. This is too slow. Ta 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 ta. Ta 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 ta. Yes. Maximum speed. Tracking. I would drive just like this in SnowRunner too, if only there were roads. On the roads I would drive like this. 100%. Hello, Autogrill! Do you know what's the Autogrill? The Autogrill is the typical service station in Italy. They're all over the country. I don't know if they're called Autogrill outside of Italy as well. I guess Autogrill is just the name of the company that owns and manages them. But I'm not so sure, actually.
Tenersi a destra e poi uscire a destra.
Keep to the right and then exit to the right. Su Zara and Verona. Oh, there's an accident. I guess I can just sound the horn and pass through, no? That's the tracker's way. Shall we go? No, eh? I don't fit. But I do fit. Look at this. No problem. How much did I damage my track, actually? Quite a bit, I think. Unfortunately, I was going pretty fast. Yeah, 7%, but it was already 5, I think. Worth it. Worth it. What truly matters is to go fast, of course. Like Sonic. Not worry about the consequences. Okay. I'll have to fix this track once we are in Verona. Not a big problem, of course. We got plenty of money to spare. Perhaps I should buy an extra garage as well. I guess I have the money now. But perhaps more in like the center of Europe. The garage I have in Rome is kind of annoying to use. You always start in the central part of the peninsula, so wherever you have to go it takes ages. I need a more central garage to teleport to, at the very least. Lombardia, we're finally in Lombardia, northern region of Italy, where indeed Verona sits. And another accident. What is it today? Ah, with the helicopter too. God damn it! I don't think I can pass through here. Well, but then again, what are you supposed to do once you arrive here? What if I was too stupid to... I keep destroying my track by doing this. I think you can pass through this, I'm sure I have in the past. In reality you wouldn't fit. And apparently you don't here either. Okay, and now what? I dive all the way past the intersection? I think so, I think so. Unless I want to completely destroy the track. Okay, no problem like that. It's okay, it's okay. We got all the road for us. In fact, why is there so little traffic? Yes, this time my grand plan didn't work, it seems. How incredibly acrobatic and dangerous. And of course, this has just lengthened my path by quite a bit, but what can have you? Sometimes the accidents are present and you gotta take them into account. I remember passing through when the helicopter was there, like I did the first time, but apparently it cannot be done anymore. Or maybe not on that road anyway. What a discovery. And what a way to discover it, by breaking the track some more. Indeed, by breaking the track some more. And now I gotta pay the toll as well. How annoying. You truly hate me today, Truck Simulator. Then go around at the roundabout. And I presume come back through it. Oh, with traffic is more fun. I don't think I'll play online again. I mean, online is fun, but traffic is better. Online was like driving in a post-apocalyptic world. Only some trucks, here and there, and nothing else whatsoever. Horrible. I want to feel like I'm driving on a real road, not in a post-apocalyptic wasteland. I'm sure they could have traffic in multiplayer if they really wanted. Well, maybe not with a player-managed infrastructure like the Trackers MP mod. That would require the actual game to support multiplayer, I guess. But I best not dwell on that, this is what we get for the time being. I go straight here, right? Yes, I'm going to Verona. I'll have to fix my track once I'm there. That little meeting with the helicopter wasn't extremely healthy for its well-being, unfortunately. I'm supposed to go 40. Do I care? No, because we're no longer online. I'm the master of my house. I can go however fast I want today. Big improvement indeed. I how far now? 85 kilometers. 85 kilometers are not that much in Euro Truck lore. The new sound of the horn, yes, I like it. Puts everything into perspective, doesn't it? What are we, if not children, playing with oversized toys along the roads of our own country? Yes. No interest for the service area, got plenty of fuel indeed. Can just keep driving. 125, let's push it. Let's bring the engine to its maximum rev power. 130. And sound the horn preemptively. Yeah, don't you dare. 132. Ah, oh, I love it. Finally, I can go however fast I want. No annoying several wide limits for us today. And here is where we go to the fair city of Verona.
Tenersi a destra.
Also Venice is this way, it seems. Venice and its beaches. Not the Venice beach that you might think about, but the beach of Venice, case in point. The original one, in a way. I've been once in my life to Venice. I was a kid at the time, but you don't forget a place like that. It's kind of incredible, really. Unique in the entire world.
Venirsi a destra e poi...
Of course we're not going there today. Not today. We gotta build a new bridge of Genoa.
Uscire a destra.
Exit to the right. To the southern part of Verona, indeed. Wasn't Verona the city of Romeo and Juliet, I think, no? Shakespearean tragedy. I'm not sure Shakespeare had ever been to Verona. Rather sure he hadn't, actually. He took some liberties with the culture and the time. Okay. And this is the toll booth again. You know it's Italy because you got 10,000 toll booths. That's absolutely realistic, as I was saying yesterday. And we are almost in Verona now. Honk for annoyance that I gotta pay. Dun, dun.
Prepararsi a voltare a destra.
Prepare turning to the right.
Voltare a destra.
Ok. Where can I fix my truck? Apparently, if I move further and turn to the right, you have the track fixing place, the track garage, I guess you can call it. I don't know how you would call it in English. The service area? No, the service area is where you buy fuel, I guess, and food if you need. Okay. Hoping that they pay attention to my signal. And they did, and they did. Here we are. Repair. 17,000 euros of damage, huh? Not bad, not bad. Well, but it's several weeks worth of damage, huh? Today I did the most of it, I think, when I had a little run-in with the police helicopter, but then again, it's all part of the trucker's experience. I must buy a garage. Now I have the money. I will soon. Okay. Plenty of room to maneuver here. Gotta be careful when I get back on the road that my trailer doesn't catch the fence, no? No, but I can see through the rear view mirror that it's not likely to happen. Unfortunately, I don't have very good visibility to the left. In fact, I was risking it. I'm half tempted to, yes. It's not ideal. I wonder how the real trackers do it. For me, it's absolutely lacking in terms of rear visibility. I mean side visibility. Okay. Honk for maximum effect while crossing the intersection, of course. Of course.
Voltare a destra.
don't I look silly now? Waiting for my turn forever and ever. Oh! Watch out, you just fixed this baby.
Voltare a sinistra.
And now? I would let the huge truck pass myself. If I saw he wanted to, no? Ok, you got the idea. Ruling the road.
Eccoci arrivati.
As is my right. The birthright of the tracker. Ok. Let's park it. Let's park it wherever you want me. Oh, this looks difficult. This looks difficult indeed, because you don't have much room to park it. Let me see. No, actually it's fairly big. Oh, what the hell. Okay, so let me think. To achieve this, I think I'm supposed to go. Yeah. Well, external makes everything easier, let's say the truth. I'm supposed to go all the way through the turn. Like this, I guess. Then bring the... Oh, god damn it. This is why you do it in internal. Did I damage the track? No. Luckily not, despite the two big bumps that I gave. Okay, let me think. Yes, it should more or less function like this. First you align the trailer, then you align the cabin. No, but actually there's plenty of room. Not as problematic as it looked. I think... well, yeah, it will take more than one maneuver. This is a bit too much, wait a sec. I think I overdid it. okay. Don't know why I did it like this. It seemed correct. No, no, but it is, it is. And now... Yes. No. Still too much. I have too much of a heavy hand when I do these things. I think... No? No? Wait, I'm doing the same thing. Why didn't I turn the... No, now you're not shifting. I mean, all you gotta do is straighten it. Okay. And then... I'm a bit out of practice, huh? But don't overdo it. Yes, just the correct... amount. The more I do this thing, the worse I seem to be at it. Ah. I don't think the game will accept it, unfortunately. In fact, it did. Oof. Well, not the cleanest parking job, but I got the idea more or less. And most of all, I got the job done. And now we can actually take care of the special event. So. The special event is an external contract job that says, supposedly, well, first of all, it should bring me to Genoa, I guess. There is one here, but it's, I don't know if it's for the event. Well, it's construction and equipment. Let me see the event information again. Yes, it's the CA SRL Ovest and Est. In theory, you gotta do 6 jobs for each. Okay. So, returning to the job offerings. The construction company. No, this one. From Verona to Genoa. Okay. It's not a long job, of course, but you have to do 10 of them. Might take a while. Start delivery. are strangely motivated when they have these special events. It makes everything more interesting, I guess. For me, at least.
Okay, andiamo.
Unfortunately, it will be night. Okay, let's get this load on the track now. This cargo, I always say load. I think a cargo is more correct, isn't it? But wait a sec. I think I left it behind. Yes, it was there. I was so sure it would be here, but actually, no, it was there. Can you imagine? Whee! Whee! Everything's easier when you're driving just a cab and don't have the trailer. That's what makes everything more complicated. Mm-hmm. And attach.
Andiamo.
Let's go. 500 kilometers, huh? I would have thought it to be closer. Doing 10 of the jobs won't be so simple. Oh, what did I do? Something weird, something wrong, I dare say. Eh, that's the exit. So what am I carrying exactly? An excavator, yeah. Oh, what's happening? Is it slope? I don't know. It seemed like the track was moving backwards without me doing anything. What is that? Alright. Okay. Gotta go to the right, yes. Gotta go to the right, left. Gotta go to the left, right. Oh, 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 oh. I didn't check the rear view mirror while doing it. And that's another noob mistake. What is that guy doing? That's kind of crazy. I thought it's a fairly long cargo, which is making everything hard. Okay, they don't care, these guys. What the guys, I'm getting my truck unstuck. What are you doing? I think I should just go left, honestly. Yeah? But let me try another attempt. I might hit a bush or two. I mean, if you can save 10 meters. These guys were kind of crazy. I'm not going around unless I absolutely have to. There is no honor in that. Come on, with the red lights. You don't have to put on that red dress. Okay. Moving once again. And now making real progress toward the mission objective. Apparently they need an excavator to build a bridge, I guess. You would, maybe during the first phases of construction. Have you seen how it looked left and right? I didn't brake, I just looked left and right so that I could see that in the eye before crashing into something. At least. I guess that's a famous landmark of Verona, honestly I don't know it.
Voltare a sinistra.
Seems like a radio... Not radio, well, a telecommunications tower, I guess. It has the looks of one of these. Maybe I should turn on the lights, yes. How did I do it again? It's becoming night. Okay, unfortunately I didn't go to the telepass booth. No, I love to stop. And well, that's part of the experience too. Where is the kind sir, the kind gentleman that accepts the money? We couldn't see him. Let's just move from Milano to Venice, Bologna. Let's see. Maybe I should say Bologna when I speak English. I'm not sure. Did I take the right... Yes, it's the right exit, okay. Up the ramp we go. What's this sound? I don't like it. Did they bump the trailer? No. Okay. And now we can finally push the pedal to the metal, as they say. I need the zoom in and out buttons on my config. Otherwise the external view is just not as satisfying. Tell you what, I might want to go and do it now. Options, buttons, there will be a zoom in, zoom out function. Root advisor, view, look left, look right, rotate, zoom of the internal view. No, that's not it. Next view. No. Well, apparently they don't have a zoom in, zoom out view. Control. That's a shame. So the different views are the only way you can change the zoom, I guess. Well, let's not do it now when I'm driving more than 100 km per hour on a roadway. Maybe later when I'm parking. You actually go to Innsbruck from this way. We won't be reaching it, of course. Get back my old... Not that I look all the way there, it's freaking dangerous, but still. What are you doing? Why did you... Well, okay, I'm slower, it makes sense, it makes sense. I'm not refueling, still got plenty. The good old Italian road trip. We don't have that many here. Paradoxically, the distances seem shorter and yet people don't travel that much in country. Not by car, at least. We prefer the train and plane and all that as Italians, I would say, but maybe it's just my personal impression. Am I going too fast now? Maybe. They don't care for the turn signal, especially if you want to occupy the other road. Hey Cody, hello! Have you seen what happened, Cody? It's the first time you come since the other day. I got banned. I cannot share my stream anymore. Can you believe it? Because I don't know why. They didn't tell me. Apparently I will be able to share again on Saturday. Good morning, Cody. Indeed. It's a pretty cool game, I wanted to play it for a while, Euro Truck Simulator. We're even running the special event for the materials delivery to the new Genoa bridge. Yeah, I got banned, can you believe it? Basically, banned from posting to groups. I don't know why, it happened suddenly. I was just sharing my other page in the morning, no? My blog, which is unrelated to all this and isn't even shared as much. And I shared it once, I shared it twice. At the third time it said, ah, no, no, you have been banned until Saturday. If you want more information, go there. You go there and it just says again the same thing, so no more information. I think it was a combination of things, no? Well, on one hand, I certainly share more than the average user of Facebook. And perhaps some would say I even share too much because I always follow the tensor use, I always follow the group's policies. But still, this annoys some people. So maybe I got some people complained. And also, oh shit, I should have done. This is kind of dangerous, guys. Let's pretend I didn't do it. And well, some people complain the number of shares passed a certain limit. I think it was an algorithm that made a sum of the two, because otherwise it wouldn't have happened during the share operation. It would have happened in between sessions when someone went and actually put the measure into action. What is it today with Axie? That's the third accident I see. And so here we are. I'm still streaming, yeah, but for far less viewers. Let's share it like 8 or 9. Yes, I'll do that. Hey, you just did it for me. Thank you, Cody. I knew I could count on you. I knew I could. Anyway, it could have been worse. I mean, it's only 3 days of ban. It kind of killed my mood though, because I discovered that actually most of my viewers were just people coming from the shares. Hey, hello Kieran, you're here today as well. I mean, I got you guys, you are wonderful. You, Kieran, Cody, and others are coming and saying hello. But most of my viewership seems to have come from the shares. That's a bit disappointing. I thought that when I had come to about 1,000 followers, like I have now, I've actually well passed of them. And another like from Romulus. It's you, Romulus. Hello. I'm in Italy today. Look at this. Driving along the roads to deliver materials for the Genoa Bridge. And no, yeah, like I was saying, like I was telling Cody the story, and I told the same story this morning and yesterday as well. I'm now a pirate stream, I'm forbidden. So you're actually breaking the law to watch me. No, I joke. Of course I do. And yet it's annoying. It's annoying to go from like 20 viewers to 5 or 6 at most. Through no fault of mine. At least if they told you, no? If you could speak with someone that told you what you did wrong, I wouldn't do it again. Now, I half suspect that once I start sharing everything like before. I hear a train, where is it? Once I start sharing again tomorrow, no, I mean Saturday, I might do the same mistake again. The game won't tell me. The game, I mean the social network, will not. It's all up in the air, so to speak. Imagine the people that actually make their living through streaming on YouTube and all that. You hear these stories from time to time. You're still relying on a private platform, no? A private service that can take everything away whenever it feels like it. Should make the ad tracking a bit less sensitive, I guess. Was a bit too jerky. At least we can enjoy the same cool games, that won't change. Whatever kind of measure they might put into
Tenersi a
action,
destra e
indeed.
poi uscire a destra.
Ok, keep to the right, it says. Been wanting to play this game again for the
Uscire a
longest
destra.
time. I was afraid I wouldn't be able to stream it, because after doing it in the beginning, I found myself almost unable to continue speaking. Now, luckily, I learned a skill at the very least. Now I can speak again and again about nothing. I've become a true streamer. I think you can have them review it. Yeah, but it's not really worth it. You see, it was just 3 days. Even if they actually reviewed it, they would have reviewed it along the course of the next 48 hours at the very least. It wasn't worth it if it was a longer. But anyway, I think it's just an algorithm. They even tell you, we will try and make improvements to our methods based on your appeal, but we won't be able to solve the cases on a case-by-case basis. And in fact, I didn't expect they would. It wasn't worth it, not for this kind of light measure that was put into action. No, but the unfortunate thing is not knowing the reason. Is not knowing the reason. I can presume, I can assume some people complained, but from which group? Why? But anyway, these groups have rules, they have written rules, and I never post to groups that have no streamer policy, no? I've been banned from sharing, and then after the review, I never got banned since. Ah, really? So for you it worked, eh? Well, then I'll ask for a review as well. If you tell me this, I will ask for a review. I'll go and ask for it, I still can. I'm half tempted to just write to them, you see, to ask for information. Try and understand what the heck happened. I mean, I'm providing free content and entertainment for both the people that might enjoy it and the social network as a whole. I don't think I'm hurting anyone. Probably the only thing that I do different from others is that I play so much. And that's, I think, the root of the problem. The fact that streaming twice a day, my stream is always there, is always present. So perhaps this is the word way of telling me stream less, sad as it is. It's just not intended, no, for a small time streamer like me to share his streams twice a day, every day. It's all a strange system, I'm not sure. It's almost like they don't want new names to succeed in this world. The entire castle of streaming is built on this type of concept, that you gotta be big to remain big, and if you're small you will never become that. Weird as it might sound. And it's a bit disheartening, it kills the mood, sort of like. Still, here we are. I might get annoyed to the point of stopping, I'm not sure. We'll see. Don't get scared if you don't see me tomorrow. Tomorrow I'm just occupied, I'm just busy. There are some things that I gotta sort out. So tomorrow I won't stream, but for other reasons, I guess. And then the day after tomorrow, we'll see. Then again, I might even stream tomorrow for what I know. Fact of the matter is that I still enjoy this. I still enjoy to be with you guys. But what makes me suffer is that it's unfair, you see. You see so much stupid shit on Facebook. Stuff that has no reason to even be posted, no? While providing hours and hours of gameplay that people might care about. Someone might like it, no? It's free, I mean. Why would it be unwanted? God damn it, it's not like I'm asking for anything in return. What's this? Wait a sec. Ah, it's just an advertisement, okay. Good thing I didn't do a crash while looking at the cell phone. It was good while it lasted, what can I say, at this point. Just trolls. Yes, I suspect it's a bit like that. The problem is, when you get just an isolated complaint, Facebook doesn't care that much. But after time and time again, of course, they had to do something. It's an automated system mostly, no? There is not a human on the other side. They go by numbers, by averages. And there are some people that just don't want you to play in VR. Hey Gary, hello. They just hate VR as a wall. I've seen it happen. They use the most weird terms, like they say VR kills people. Stupid as it might sound, I got even that type of remark previously. Okay, they let me through already, yes, because I got the telepass automated system for paying of the toll booth. Hi Christopher, hola! Christopher from Peru, hello, hello. Still doing the truck delivery missions today. Genoa Bridge, a special event. We're going, hola, yeah, I knew you would say that. We're going to build a new bridge in Genoa. It's a special event for the game. Kind of fun, I mean, I like the idea.
Uscire a destra.
Exit to the right, to Genoa. I wish we had a South America truck simulator. That would be cool to visit, to see new places, no? I mean, we got the North American game. We might as well have the South American one.
Tenersi a sinistra.
Okay, now we gotta let the car pass, and then I guess we can occupy the road and go. Oh yes, no problems like that. Life's looking good despite everything. Don't you dare! Don't you dare! Okay, they didn't dare. Wow, but road lightning really sucks in Italy. This is not so realistic, I tell you. The major roadways tend to be lighted pretty well. As I'm about halfway through my fuel tank, I should find a service area, I guess. Hey, thank you for the like. Nippon, I know you, welcome back to the stream, I know your name. I wanted to go to the other toll booth, but now it's too late. That was better. That's the type of toll booth where you don't have to stop, but unfortunately. You know, now sometimes you get a bug where it doesn't activate, you have to go backwards and then forward again. In fact, look what happened. I pressed T. And I think I actually, yeah, detached my, yes, trailer, that cannot be, it's the bug, if a car comes behind you while doing this, you become unable to pass through the toll booth, you actually have to reload, annoying as it is, luckily it's not our case today. No, but the most amazing thing is that you stop, you press the button that it tells you to press, which is T, and that detaches the tire. Once to me it happened in the first days I was playing this game, that I actually drove all the way to my destination without a trailer, if you can believe it. Isn't that crazy, yeah. But it's fair, all is good. We're almost getting to Genoa now, at least we'll see the bridge. I think the game still has the old bridge in place. Because otherwise you wouldn't be able to drive to the other side of the river. You know the story of the Morandi Bridge? It's a pretty sad story, actually. It happened beginning of last year. It was a fairly old bridge, built in the 60s, I think. Ciao Paolo, ehi, buongiorno, benvenuto sullo stream. Stiamo facendo l'evento speciale di Genova per costruire il nuovo ponte. L'hanno lanciato oggi in Euro Truck Simulator. Interessante, no? And like I was saying, the bridge basically, it was built in the 60s by a rather famous architect. It was very futuristic for the time and very well built, but unfortunately along the years, hi Bernardo, hey, welcome to the stream, thank you for joining. And unfortunately they didn't do the maintenance properly. For some reason or other, there was some mismanagement in the company that was supposed to do the maintenance for the bridge, and after so many years the bridge suddenly went down. The bridge, basically the bridge got undone while it was being used. Some 40 people died, it was quite a tragedy. Beginning of last year about. And so, since then basically Genoa has no bridge, they've been building the replacement one. It's been a major story here in Italy. The new one is being built from the project of an architect which basically gave it away for free for his good name, I guess. Pro bono, as they say in the US. It's Renzo Piano, you might have heard of him. And now we will have Renzo Piano's bridge in Euro Truck Simulator as well, after the players themselves build it. So you're supposed to complete 10 missions of delivery of materials for the new bridge, or like in my case, actually machinery for building it. This is an excavator. I don't know why you would need an excavator to build a bridge, but anyway, we best not go too much into the details for it. 10 missions, and you get some nice rewards. There is, a new livery for the truck, and they give you also a little hanging toy, no? The thing that you hang on top of the cabin, I don't know the English name for it. That's kind of nice, it's a way to commemorate the event. It's a way to pay homage as well, I mean, it's a game, it's all for fun. Hey Paolo, okay, I'm close to Genoa now, I think. I was driving from Verona to Genoa. I started in Rome, because my garage is there. In fact, I picked a mission for delivering it to Verona, which is, according to the game guide, one of the cities where you get the materials for the Genoa Bridge. So now I'm not sure, actually. I can show you the map if you want. I'm not very good at geography myself, not even the geography of Italy. Well, now it would be kind of dangerous, I guess. Look at the situation. This is a pretty interesting place, by the way. No, but the game pauses. We're not online. I can't look at the map. We're almost there. We're in Liguria, I guess. Here you have it. I didn't know this particular area was so mountainous. So, oh, well, that's kind of unusual. What the heck? A plane landed in between the two tunnels. Can you imagine that? A crash landing of the plane in between the two tunnels. What the heck is this, guys? That's kind of surreal. That's kind of surreal. Okay. Never seen it myself before today. This game is full of surprises, I guess. I best honk for appreciation. I'm gonna keep to the left, it seems. Yes, to go to Genoa. To the right you go to France, actually, to Nice. I know the road very well. I think they reconstructed some location very accurately. When I drive around Rome, I do recognize some places. But Rome in particular is a bit barren. They didn't really go into the reconstruction of the city itself. Not even its outskirts, I guess. They don't have many landmarks. Paradoxically, some of the smaller cities or the more... I think the north of Italy in general is made better. The graphics pretty good anyway for the Italian DLC, because it's one of the more recent ones, no? It came out like a couple of years ago, no longer than that. The game is way older. This is an ancient game nowadays. What time is it now? 4 in the morning, okay, will be day soon. Every time I look at that thing, I swerve to the left. It's hella dangerous. 29 kilometers to the destination. I guess we are going to drop the excavator at the bridge itself. We will get to see the bridge, I wonder. And then, of course, we gotta go to another one of the cities where the mission brings us, yes. It's getting foggy. That's typical of northern Italy. It is well known that in the north you have plenty of fog, but in fact in the winter around Rome is just as bad. It's less of a stereotype, but I can say to you for sure, because I used to work out of town, that as soon as you leave the city of Rome in the winter, you'd find a lot of snow. How does it work here? I'm supposed to go to the right, I guess. That's kind of annoying, though. I think this is where you went to the bridge originally. Okay. We just lengthened our... I cannot go straight. For what I know, I might go to the actual bridge that doesn't exist any longer. I don't know if they actually modeled it in the game. Now we'll have to go around some way. Yeah, you gotta pay at the toll booth, unfortunately. No way around it. Then I guess past the toll booth I should be able to turn around. No, actually, not here at least. No, maybe past of it I can, actually, yes. I would be arrested 10,000 times. I'm certainly not supposed to do it. No, but there's no room. It would be crazy, actually, to do it here. There's no room to turn around such a long track. Yeah, I gotta go all the way to where it's actually broader. I'm half tempted to just do it and fuck it. After all, it's a game, no? Yeah, but turning around here is a massacre waiting to happen. You have to go to town and then turn around, I guess. Unfortunately, today I find 10,000 accidents wherever I go, for some reason or other. Just too narrow, just too narrow. Here's Genoa. Here you have it. It's a very charming city. It's a port town since the days of old. Okay. And here, I presume, I can go maybe... I'm not sure. Well, let's just use the roundabout at this point. I was so tempted to do something crazy at this point, but it's not just not worth it. We have the roundabout. The famous roundabout of Genoa. These people drive like madmen. Here, who's talking? Come on. We got our friendly polizia there, the police, and also the carabinieri. Did you know? We have two types of police in Italy. Carabinieri are actual the military policemen of Italy. They perform more or less the same things, in addition to some others, because they're actually trained as soldiers, unlike the policemen. So they do a different type of work, but they also deal with traffic, they also deal with the daily needs of civil management, I guess, what you would expect from the police, case in point. Okay, now finally we are almost at our destination. Unfortunately, got to drive back. This is the ending of the city. I guess I should say the border, yeah, the border of town. I guess these are really there, the typical soundproof barriers. I see some of these here in Rome as well. I think they're fairly common in Italy, because of the regulations that we have in place. Okay, and now, if only there wasn't that accident or whatever that made me turn the wrong way, we would be there already. But unfortunately, yes, this is also track simulator. It's not always a straight road to your destination. Turn to the right. They seem to have missed a couple of signs. They're just arrows with nothing written in them. How peculiar. How peculiar indeed. Okay, and now we're getting to the bridge, I guess. Finally, day is breaking. I can't turn off my headlights. Yes, here you have it. Basically, they block you before you can reach the bridge, yes. So you come here. Am I in alignment here? More or less. Wait a sec, did they manage to... they're fairly strict, these guys. You gotta place the trailer in the correct place. Okay. Makes sense, makes sense. No, wait, I'm turning... Why do I do it every time? I'm turning the wrong way. No, I won't do like this. Now you will discover how much I suck at parking trucks, if you haven't already. Okay, now straighten this goddamn cabin. Okay. Like this, I guess. Should work. Yes. No, because the game is kind of anal. No, okay, no, no. It's okay. So, unload the cargo and mission completed. Now I only have to do it another 9 times. Ooh, there's even a cutscene. They're actually building the goddamn bridge, look at it. That's freaking cool. Ah, this is the actual place where they're building the bridge. It was kind of incredible, no? The old bridge, basically, was run like 1 meter from the houses. That was the most amazing thing when they shown it in the news. And basically the bridge was resting on the houses. They completely had to raise the entire district when they removed the remaining rubbles of the bridge. It was a very sad state of affair, really. Make me say, take the thing that makes you save fuel. Okay. And now we gotta go fetch extra materials. So, East Depot or West Depot? The East Depot comes next, in theory. Let me see what we have around here. I hope there is one close by, because otherwise I'll have to drive to one of the cities where you get them. But I think I will, probably. Let's see. I'm looking for the jobs from the construction company. This one. Yes, but this is from Genoa to some other place. I need the jobs that bring me to Genoa. And of course I won't find any in Genoa. Doesn't work like this. So I guess I want to go to one of the neighboring cities, because according to the job, you can get these jobs in Turin, Milan, Verona, Suzzara, Parma, Bologna, Florence and Livorno. So basically all the surrounding cities. So I need some job that brings me to one of these, because I might as well earn along the way. From Genoa to Berna, Milano. Here you have it. It's a pretty short job, and in Milan I will find some more materials to bring to Genoa. Okay, makes sense, no? I guess it would. No, it was incredible. I remember when they shown it in the news. I was like amazed. The pylon of the bridge was resting. Resting, I tell you. On the building. Imagine these people that own the houses. And they, when they came and built the bridge, they basically put the bridge. What the heck did I do, guys? I just took the wrong type of job. Am I still in my own track? No, no, I am in my own track. It's correct, it's correct. No, because strangely I got moved from where I was. I think it's a pre-calculated thing. I'm not sure. No, this is not my track. It's just green like mine, but it's Mercedes. Okay. I gotta reload. I do always the same mistake. Instead of going for autonomous job, I picked an employee job. Hi, Gabriele. Ehi, ciao. Benvenuto. Ho sbagliato, aspetta. Devo ricaricare la partita. Autosaves. L'ho fatto anche ieri. Yes, the one at the mission completion. Yesterday I did the same goddamn thing. I selected the wrong type of job. Will take just a moment, I promise. Okay. I guess this was on mission delivery, yes. So go to the menu again. The mission remains completed, but let me pick the correct type of job now. It's autonomous job. Okay, always the same mistakes from me. So from Genova to Milan, we have one. Perfect, medical equipment. This is also in team with the days, I guess. And now I'm actually in my track and heading for the correct place. Okay. What's happening? Okay. Ah yeah, if I don't turn on the engine. I gotta buy fuel as well, I don't have that much. Tenersi a destra e poi uscire a destra. Without a trailer, I'll even move quicker. Yes. It's not that far, just 24 kilometers, which in Truck Simulator is not 24 real kilometers, it's way less. The river where the bridge is running is called the Polcevera River. Well, it's more like a creek, I guess, than a river. And basically it split the town in half. From what I heard at the time, now of course I live very far from Genoa, but from what they were saying, life in the city has become way harder since the bridge no longer exists. Traffic is terrible. There were people that took the bridge every day. And in fact some of these people live like a final destination moment, no? When the bridge went down, they took a detour for some reason and they were a bit later and they saved their own lives. Then there were stories even crazier of people that just by mere minutes they didn't die. There was a guy that was became famous. He went to all the major news channels and basically his truck, he was driving an actual truck, was left hanging from the bridge when the bridge went down. For mere meters he survived with no kind of injuries, crazy as it might seem. And entire families have died instead, and well, it was a sad state of affairs. There is a fuel station. I need fuel. I need fuel. There is no fuel station here. Come on, guys.
Uscire adesso.
And now, of course, it starts to rain. It's actually the way to the airport, I guess. Yes, we're going to fetch medical equipment. I guess it's coming from the... from abroad.
Prepararsi a voltare a sinistra.
Okay. Highlights are on, yes. Where is it? Here, I think. Okay.
Qui termina il nostro viaggio.
Let me through. Yes. And now let me see this job that brings me to Milan. Ah, wait a sec, I can look at the external contacts as well. This pay more in general. But it must bring me to one of the cities where you get materials for Genoa, and it doesn't. And then no external job for us, but rather the normal autonomous job. And it's no more. What the heck? No, wait, makes no sense. I could see it before I came to here. I think they've refreshed the jots. That's annoying as hell. Are there other companies nearby that I can go through? Someone else took the job before me, I guess. Ah yes, there are other companies indeed. I could go there, for instance. But why do I have already... What's happening? Delete all waypoints. Okay. Let's go to the other company, I guess. Ah, there's also fuel here. Wait. I think that's more urgent. Let's go pick the fuel, and then these companies along the road, I hope they will have the job I seek.
Tutto è pronto. Possiamo partire.
That's annoying, though. Someone got to the job before me and stole it from me! How's that for metagaming? Emergent gameplay, competition and all that. It's just a fantasy, eh, guys. Actually, there is no player-to-player interaction in Truck Simulator, but then... it makes for a cool headcanon, so to speak. Okay. Oh. After the blue car. While sounding the horn, of course. So moody with the rain. Kind of cool, really. This is when the game is more immersive, I guess. The sound of the rain on the tracks, glass. No, what's the name of the parabrezza? Not sure the English word for the front. No, glass of a vehicle. I don't remember it at the moment. I'm sure I know. The windshield, yes. The windshield. Here's another Carabinieri car. Hi, Carabinieri. And here you can see a Mini. It's actually a proper Mini. They download a mod or something. I don't think they would have the Mini license, but that was pretty clearly a goddamn Mini car.
Uscire adesso.
Interesting. I guess they missed the 10,000 smart cars that you would have in Rome. When you go around Rome, you would actually expect to see more smart rather than other cars. These things are hella popular in Rome because parking and traffic are so bad. In fact, I do drive a smart car. And many others that I know do. It's one of the few things that make the city of Rome actually livable. Okay, here we finally get our fuel. And stop. Stop the engine. Il pieno grazie, as you would say in Italian. Fill her up, I guess. And having done that, there were some companies further along the road, right? I can go to any of like 5 or 6 different cities, so let's go job hunting. I will find one, no? Oh, visibility sucks. I got a chat with the external view. I don't know how you could do it in real life, you just wouldn't see the road. One of the companies is here to the right, it seems. Huh? Unfortunately, this game, as soon as you get into a city, the frame rate worsens considerably. Not to the point that you will notice in normal gameplay, but in VR it does hurt you. There's no way around it, I'm afraid. In fact, I try to stay in the cities, the less the better. Okay. Let's see what they have here. So, lavoro autonomo, indeed. From Genoa to Ginevra, completely useless, completely. What the hell, guys? External contract? Strasburgo, Roma e Porto Vecchio. None of these do. Should I just drive to Milan and call a day? I don't know. Starting to think like that, annoying as it is. There is another company I think I can visit here. Well, in fact, there's another two. Yes, let's go there.
Andiamo.
For people that connected now, I'm trying to do the Genoa Bridge event, but I don't want to go to the cities where I get the materials without some materials in turn, because it makes for a waste trip, no? I want to make money every leg of the journey. That's the idea, anyway. So, let's find a proper job that brings me to one of these cities. Might be too difficult of an idea, unfortunately. What's this? Let me through! Okay. Well, I can see shit as always to the right. Apparently I won't kill anyone today. Let's go. No time to waste. I gotta do 10 jobs to bring the materials to Genoa. I think after this one I'll just drive super fast to the next place to get the materials, because this way makes it fairly impossible to achieve. Bo, what the fuck? 2% damage for that tiny bump. What is this? SnowRunner? Like the other day when I destroyed the truck for no reason. Okay. Another Mini. Everyone driving a Mini. This is the port of Genoa, as you can see. And if we lost something that goes to Milan or Verona or any other of the 10,000 towns that... Ah, there is no type of deliveries from this one company. It's getting crazier and crazier. External contract. Linz, Tolosa, Olbia, Ajaccio, Bastia, Lione, Milano. Oh! Milano, finally. I want to go to Milan. Milan will give me the materials I need. From Genoa to Milan. Animal food. Pet food, I guess. Nice. For the dogs and kittens of Milan, I guess. They also need to eat, don't they? This is also a worthwhile, important mission. Okay. Let's get this pet food on board. Now watch me fail miserably even at the simple job of attaching the trailer. No, at least that I can do. At least that I manage to do most of the time on first attempt. Okay.
È ora di andare.
300 kilometers to Milan. From Genoa to Milan. Is that realistic? I guess, more or less. It would be the real distance. Of course, they won't be to scale in the game. Otherwise, it would take hours, or at least an hour, I guess. Well, not properly. It would take at least three. With an average of 100 km per hour, case in point.
Prepararsi a voltare a sinistra.
Ah, it stopped raining? Okay, didn't notice. I was so taken in my fantasy of the trigger that... yes, but now we stopped it. Of course, we didn't have the sound that the wind wiper, makes, no? When you don't have water on the windscreen. That goes like... and that would have reminded me to stop it, indeed.
Voltare a sinistra.
We could just refuel here. Well, it's not like I took a detour. I was just desperately looking for a place that would give me the proper job, and apparently in the end I found it. Unfortunately, external contacts make you respect the speed limit, more or less. Anyway, I cannot go as crazy fast as I did on my way in.
Voltare a destra.
Look at the nice restaurant over there. Ooh. With all the umbrellas. I think Genoa is also a pretty touristic city. But most of Italy is. Or at least was. Nowadays, you gotta think about it in the past tense, sadly. We'll see. We'll see what the future holds for us. Oops! That would have been a bit... No, but it's okay. Look at the police! Even policemen pay for the toll booth, you see? How realistic. Okay, now straight and then... But what the hell? Is another accident detour? I don't know. No, just the police stop there. No, actually down there is something wrong. Today I've encountered 10,000 different accidents. Ten jobs is a lot, huh? To get the reward. 10 jobs, guys. You only completed one job since I started playing. Granted, I had to move here from Rome. But then... 10 is 10 times what we will have done once I come back from Milan. Well, let's say 5 times, because of course at that point I will have 2 jobs completed. And also you gotta complete them from specific companies, 5 each. They really make them more hard than they ought to be. And the problem is another, once people complete the event, it's done, and knowing the kind of community that this game has, how dedicated it is, it will be done before the weekend. So it's absolutely important to be extremely fast in mission completion.
Tenersi a destra e poi uscire a destra.
Exit to the right.
Uscire a destra.
Imagine if I tip the track here. You have much less of an excuse compared to SnowRunner, but it can happen. It happens usually when you drive extremely fast and you take a sharp curve. And then, yes, you actually can lose control to the point of tipping over. It happened to me at least a couple of times. I've seen it happen to other streamers as well. Wow, that's pretty cool. Another very tall bridge. Where are we right now? It's the same place we were driving originally, yes. When we came to here. Hey, you know, Italy has a lot of... uneven terrain, we got at least 2 major mountain chains, and then you have all the valleys and the sloped terrain all over. It's quite the country. The nature is beautiful if you've never been here, not just the history that most people seem to be into. But I best not turn into the tourism agency for the... Then again, I see there are more unworthy endeavors. This is an international stream, isn't it? After all, I do speak English. What's the hold up here? What's the hold up? The works. everything against me, but they fought John. If only they could be so operative in real life as well. Normally you see two guys at the most sitting there. Maybe one works, the other gives him advice. There is something wrong with the head tracking compared to yesterday. I guess I should make it more sensitive. I'm lacking the one-to-one, or maybe makes me feel a bit queasy. No, I should reduce it, I guess. Unfortunately, when you do things with vortex like I have, sometimes it's just not ideal for nausea and the like. Ooh, I did it again. I detached the trailer instead of paying the toll booth.
Andiamo.
The important thing is noticing it, otherwise you just leave it behind, and that's not the best thing to do. As you can see, it didn't happen, so it's alright. There's no unzoomed view that I could use, no, unfortunately.
Tenersi a destra e poi uscire a destra.
Ok, finally in sight of Milan. No, next time I don't pick a job on my way back, I guess. It's not ideal. I gotta quicken up. 10 jobs are plenty, will take a while. And if the event ends, you waste all effort basically, so it's important that I do complete it in time. Green carrier, an entire truck of salad, I guess. Well, I'm carrying pet food, who am I to talk? Pet food and salad, imagine if we crash into one another. That would be quite the outcome. Yes, there's actually an ant there, that's not salad. What did the ant say? Yes, it's... Hello, fellow trucker! We're not playing multiplayer, no, of course, this is the Genoa Bridge event. You cannot do the event in multiplayer. It's either one or the other. I wish I could listen to music. I got so many radio stations that I cannot use. That used to be the spirit of the game for me, driving with the music on, but unfortunately it's all copyrighted music, so Facebook would block the stream at that point. I best not irritate Facebook even more. Ciao Paki, ehi! Ehi Paki, ciao, ok, benvenuto. Sto facendo l'evento Ponte di Genova. È partito oggi. Ma l'hanno fatto difficile, 10 consegne da due aziende diverse, 5 l'una. Fatta una sola finora. Adesso sto andando a Milano, dove spero di trovarne un'altra da poter fare. Purtroppo niente online, perché se vuoi fare le consegne del Ponte di Genova, è l'ultima versione, quindi non c'è il mod. Però è rilassante sto gioco. L'ho scordato, è divertente a modo suo. Genova Milano, no, ora. Ti danno una colorazione per il camion, stile cantiere, tipo, a strisce gialle e nere, e poi ti danno un pendolino con uno scavatore. Così. Però in effetti è dura perché 10 lavori, che poi tra l'altro finirà in 2 giorni, perché lo sai com'è sto gioco, no? Tutte le volte fanno evento, 500.000 consegne le fanno in 24 ore, manco fosse una questione di vita e morte, durano poco, per cui fare 10 consegne in quel tempo, beh, la vedo molto complicata. Però peccato, è la cosa più divertente. Gli eventi, non so perché. Li trovo molto coinvolgenti, a modo mio. Hanno migliorato il suono del clacson, secondo me, con l'ultima patch. Questa Snazzy Black Track with the Flame Pattern. Wow. Agility. I guess it would be some kind of energy drink. C'è Royal, guarda. Gli assomiglia, no? Giallo e rosso. Beh, il mio Royal almeno era così. Royal di SnowRunner. No need to stop. Wasting fuel. And brake durability. LKV, Walter. Transport organization. I guess this guy is convinced that he will be ahead of me. And in fact,
Tenersi a sinistra.
I ended up being such a scaredy cat that I let him pass. This cannot be. Ah, he's gone to the left. I wanted that race. I wanted that race. In VR you actually risk getting distracted by the panorama because you don't have a field of view that is as wide as real life. So if you look to the side because you saw something interesting, you're going to crash 100%. When I look like this, I basically lose sight of what I had unlike real life because you're still looking through a screen anyway. We're not yet at the point where the FOV goes from the side of your actual field of view, human field of view.
Tenersi a destra e poi uscire a destra.
Corsico, what's Corsico? I guess it's a district of Milan, I don't know. I don't know, I
Uscire
think
a
I've been to
destra.
Milan only once. Same trip where I was to Venice. And same as that, I was indeed very young.
Tenersi a sinistra e poi voltare a sinistra. Voltare a sinistra.
I'm carrying pet food, guys, if you can believe it. Oh, look at that, Barilla. That's an actual pasta company in Italy that makes pasta. Stop violence. Okay, gender violence. It was interesting. This I think these billboards come from the mod that I installed with realistic billboards. They even have, yes, a gender violence billboard. Stop violence, stop abusing women, essentially. Well, that looks a bit unreal. The other one about some kind of jacket. This is a McDonald's, I guess. Cemental. Cemental is also a real company. Makes canned meat. I ate plenty of Cemental in my time. It's very convenient. And I guess it tastes decent for being canned meat. Okay. We're finally in Milan. Here comes the part that I love the most. We gotta park this thing. Let's do it. Let's try not to resemble idiots for a change. È stato un bel viaggio. Okay, where do you want? Ooh, I didn't. What happened? Okay, no, for some reason I have another path on the GPS. I don't know why. For a second I thought it was a bug that told me to go somewhere else to deliver this thing. I have no idea. Well, let's just ignore it. Unfortunately, I skipped the screen that showed where to park it, but I presume it's behind here. Let me see. Here you have it. Okay. So, not the hardest one, but still a challenge for me, I guess. I'm supposed to turn the track first and foremost. And I don't know if I have the room here, honestly. Let's use the last meter that I have, yeah, more or less like this. I'm not sure I have the room. Okay. No, no, I do. And now, the other problem is, will it straighten? Let's see. Well, it's not that long. Yes, it's pretty good, I dare say. Ooh! And now, start making it go. No, I think I should make it, honestly. I should make it on first try. Let me see. Maybe I shouldn't speak so soon. In fact, I already made this usual silly mistake of turning the wheel too much. So now I gotta turn it too much on the other side, which is not too much in this case, but rather corrects the previous mistake, and then left-right, it's like a pendulum. You can tell I'm a scrub because I do it like a pendulum, and I think I just overdid it. Wait. Okay. I mean, more or less. Unless it's too anal. No, but it's moving in the correct direction now, more or less. Yeah, oh, a bit forward. So, is it a first try? I guess first try and a half. And deliver. Perfectly on time. On time. Doo-doo! Excellent! Continue. Okay, and now we can actually find for one of the Genoa Bridge jobs. Then I gotta do this. It's an external job, so did I select the proper thing? Wait, let me make sure, because otherwise we're just wasting our time. Job offering, external contract. Okay, so something that brings me to Genoa. Accio, Nizza, Graz, Lione, Zurigo, Ancona, Mannheim, Montpellier, Strasburgo, Nizza, Lione, oh, Verona, Parma, Milano, Milano, Torino. No, there is none. And what now? Am I royally screwed? That's kind of crazy, though. Try to update them. I don't think they change, right? Gotta go to somewhere else. Wow, that's annoying though. It even says very clearly that you gotta go to Milan among other cities to find jobs of this type. So what's the closest one that I can go now? Turin, I guess. Let's try Turin. Anyway, it's on my way to Genoa, so not as bad as you might think. Let's try. We will be faster without a trailer.
È ora di andare.
Off to Turin! Yeah! Ah, now we will be fast as lightning.
Prepararsi a voltare a destra.
Not respecting the speed limit at this point.
Voltare a destra.
Drive like a madman. Yes. Over the curb side, we don't care. It's a pretty fast, powerful truck, huh? It might not resemble it, but it's actually a beast of a vehicle. I got the best engine for it. The best transmission. Okay, turn left and right. Even traffic is on our side. Yes, on two wheels. Turin, to the right. ...70 speed limit, you say? A minimum of 90. Yeah! Every minute counts. Time is money. Il tempo è denaro, as we say.
Uscire a destra.
Oh. No! You want to block me? It's kind of useless, isn't it? I mean, you cannot make the car dematerialize by sounding the horn, but then again, you can pass the car on the right, and maybe you can pass the truck on the right, but it's kind of useless anyway, because look at this. There's no room. They want to slow us down no matter what. This type of driving wouldn't stand on the multiplayer server. It would get you kicked in no time. But of course we're playing single player, and so we don't care. Effing care. Pallet line. Second exit at the roundabout. So, straight basically. Just say go straight, no? Why make it complicated? I should check the mission listing from time to time, because for external jobs you have a certain reach, like around your position. It tells you the jobs that are around your position. It might actually pick on one of the special jobs. That's the construction company, for instance. Hey, Fabio, ciao, benvenuto. Stiamo facendo la missione per il ponte di Genova, evento speciale. Portare i materiali al ponte di Genova per costruire il nuovo ponte. And look at these guys. Now we have one of the missions. Unfortunately, he spawned in Milan. Basically, I have to go back. Can you believe it? But as long as he gets the job done, there is no reason to not do it. This is for the bridge, in fact. It's metal hurdles for the bridge. Gotta go back. As it is. It's 100. Oh shit! And this, guys, is why you don't look at your GPS. I might as well be crazy to the very last then. Let me turn. It will take less. Will you stop, please? No. Look at him! He was too fast! I don't know who's the more mad here. Wow, we had the fairly crazy accident here. This will cost me plenty, I'm afraid. And now I'm bumping the police car, I guess. That's even better. Everything went to shit, essentially. Let's pretend it never happened. And by whistling offhandedly leave. This wasn't my most gracious moment, I guess.
Alla rotatoria prende
The problem is what I told you. The interface puts the GPS too much to the bottom. Thank you, thank you. You see, he saw the glint of the madman's eye in my face and therefore let me pass through. Holy hell, that was some damage. So, how's my track right now? 7% damage? 8% damage. Woo! That cost about 20,000 euros to fix, I think. I mean, who cares? I'm fucking rich. I don't care. Just here for some bridge building and kicking ass. I mean, all out of bridges, I guess. If you want to get the quote. That's some video gaming quote. Of the old times. By the way, the real company that is building the new Genoa bridge is a very important heavy construction company in Italy, which is known the Salvini Impregilo. No relation to the Salvini politician. Just happened to be the same name. Ikea. Why am I respecting the speed limit now? Ah, because I picked the job in advance. Well, but anyway, I did the correct thing, otherwise someone else might pick it. Or it might disappear. This way at least I secured it and ensure I'll get the job. What an accident, guys. But in a way, no Euro Truck stream is complete without a bad accident, I guess. It's part of the appeal of the game, to witness the failure of people. And a squat little truck that is passing me. What's that? That looks fairly interesting. Weird vehicle, to say the least. Kilometers to get the job, eh? Next time I'll just wait in Milan, I'm not leaving it again. Keep to the left, it says. Just to make sure. I don't want to make another disaster to happen. I think this level of head tracking hits the nail on the head, so to speak. respecting the speed limits make everything take longer, unfortunately.
Tenersi a destra e poi uscire a destra.
Here we are. Linate is where the Milano airport is. I know that much. I know that much about Milan.
Prepararsi a voltare a sinistra.
Ah, the traffic light is an extra. We didn't expect even the traffic light. Oh, maybe the handbrake is in order. Sinistra, right, yeah, left.
Tenersi a sinistra e poi voltare a sinistra. Voltare a sinistra.
Ok.
Prepararsi a voltare a sinistra. Voltare a sinistra.
We're almost there, it seems.
Prepararsi a voltare a sinistra. Voltare a sinistra.
There is no garage to repair my truck, right? After that bad accident, I wouldn't dislike the idea of repairing it, but I'm afraid I'm not wasting even more time. Could I do this mission 10 times?
Voltare a destra e poi voltare a destra.
Turn to the right, then turn to the right.
Voltare a destra.
Yeah, you're right.
Siamo arrivati a destinazione.
Oh, there's a car. Come on, make way, man. These people have no sense of danger. And here's the medal that I gotta carry for the bridge construction. This looks very much like the medal you carry in SnowRunner, isn't it? Will feel right at home, I guess. Okay. Should attach it. Yes, it did.
Tutto è pronto. Possiamo partire.
Ok. 347 km. What time is it? I'll be able to complete this, but another one is not likely, unfortunately. During the extent of this one session.
Voltare a sinistra.
So yeah, I either play this off stream, play it two streams in a row, or I'll never complete.
Voltare a sinistra.
The mission, they really made it demanding this time. Okay. Wow. That's some cargo, guys. Allowed to be quite heavy.
Voltare a destra.
God damn it. Annoying calf. Annoying indeed.
Prepararsi a voltare a destra. Voltare a destra.
Oops. I was crashing my leg. Not the best time to do it.
Prepararsi a voltare a destra.
Yes. I don't care. I don't care. We got an important cargo here. Make way. Make way. I don't care for the lighting. For the traffic lights. I just care for the cargo delivery on time, always.
Andare dritto.
And wait a second, since I can fix the truck here. Let me see. Yes, just turn to the left, I guess. I wouldn't dislike the fixing of it. It kind of needs it, unfortunately. I mean, it's along the way. Oh! Well, that's not intended. What the heck did that guy intend to do? Well, thankfully, he didn't damage my... You have no idea, guys. Also, who designed this intersection? It's terrible! Okay.
Cerchiamo un nuovo percorso.
That gave me a good scare.
Riorientamento.
But it's okay, I guess.
Voltare a sinistra.
Scania dealership.
Non importa, troverò un nuovo percorso.
Oops. I should fit if I go more to the left, I guess. No? But what's happening, excuse me? Ah, there's a tiny, okay.
Voltare a sinistra.
You see, it's not so hard. You just gotta look at the details. And €14,000. Ah, nothing so bad. I should give this truck a bit some more flair, I guess. Put some accessories in the cabin and all that, but let's do it before the next session, I guess, not today. Okay. Ooh, look how it turns. That's excellent. Let's try not to crash into another truck, police car, I mean. That wasn't a good form, I guess. And we're out.
Prepararsi a voltare a sinistra. Voltare a sinistra e poi voltare a sinistra.
We have shit visibility to the side, unfortunately. Maybe also because I reduced the head tracking, but Hayato was giving me a nausea. Feeling of nausea, unfortunately. I'm actually occupying both lanes at the moment. Well, but there's not much I can do now, is there?
Voltare a sinistra.
Turn to the left, it says. iPhone X. You can tell the age of the mod by the fact that it's an iPhone X.
Tenersi a destra e poi voltare a destra. Voltare a destra.
Oh, this this cargo is truly heavy. Listen to the effort that the engine has to make to even move it, I mean, and we're not moving uphill either. External view is not good for my driving, I guess.
Tenersi a destra e poi uscire a destra. Uscire a destra.
Typical trucker pose, no? I lack a side window where I could actually put my elbow properly. Unfortunately, this is the best I can have. pretty stings heavy.
Tenersi a destra e poi uscire.
No, don't stop the radio, are you mad? It's forbidden. Forbidden by law for streamers.
Uscire a destra.
I will get silenced at once. Ok, turn in to the right. They're not going to Turin, I'm going to Genoa, or at least I hope. Delivering the metal hurdles, yeah, for the building of the new bridge. Another? 241 kilometers. LLS. Who's this guy? Lehman Logistics. German delivery company, I guess. Hello, hello. It's a strange feeling to be playing this again. This was the game I played at the beginning of the stream, the very first days, when I had so few viewers as I have now. I've come to full circle in a way. It's not like I have to do this. I don't know, guys. I've got so many doubts at the moment. It almost feels like I'm speaking alone most of the times, ever since I got banned. My motivation is wavering, I guess. Jacopo, come si trovano le missioni per Genova? Non riesco a trovarle. Ah, sì. È un bel casino. Sono missioni esterne, quindi devono venire da trackers online. E praticamente te lo dice lui. Se vai nel menu, guarda, ti faccio vedere, aspetta. Se tu vai qui, ti dice tutto. Operation Genoa Bridge. Praticamente sono di queste due compagnie, SRL Ovest e SRL Est. E devi fare 5 di una e 5 dell'altra. E le città che ce l'hanno sono queste. Torino, Milano, Verona, Suzzarra, Parma, Bologna, Firenze e Livorno. Genoa City itself will accept waste cargo but will not offer cargo to the depot. Non so che vuol dire. Comunque, il concetto è questo. Devi andare in una di queste città e prendere la missione esterna. Ma sono lunghe comunque. Ne devi fare 10. Secondo me è quasi impossibile. Anche perché questa domani hanno completata, lo sai come so. In 24 ore dovresti giocare qualcosa come 5 ore di seguito. Secondo me non si può fare. Stavolta l'hanno reso completamente impossibile. Questa non dura fino al weekend, capito? Ma non credo che le farò. È improponibile. Non capisco perché la devono fare così complicata. Non essere 5 in tutto, secondo me. Soprattutto considera la lunghezza. Poi guarda che te fa portare. Cioè, lo sai quanto? Questi ti rallentano pure, eh? È il metallo di SnowRunner, praticamente. Però con camion normale, no? Con quei mostri che guidi SnowRunner. Guarda che non c'hai ripresa. Capirai. E quando affitti? In più devi rispettare il limite, perché sono missioni di tracker online. Come cavolo si chiama? Tracker World, Track World.
Uscire a destra.
World of Trackers, sì. Quindi, capito? Ancora di più ci metti. Boh. Secondo me è impossibile. Ma non è che è impossibile. Te ce devi proprio mettere a proposito. Devi fare solo quello.
Tenersi a sinistra.
Just to be sure, no? Couple of honking. Dieci di queste. Ma quando affitti? 10 più andata e ritorno, perché poi devi pure raggiungere le città dove prendi la missione. Just to, no? Assert dominance. It's cool that they have these special events, but if they make them so long, then very few people will be able to complete them. The problem is, these missions normally are completed in 2 days at the most. And this is at least 5 to 6 hours of gameplay that we're looking at. It means you gotta play only this for 2 days. And you're still not sure you can get the reward. Because they might still complete the mission before you actually manage to do it. It's only for people that do nothing else all day. Then play Euro Truck Simulator, unfortunately. Marsiglia, ah, this way to Marsiglia, I guess. Still, I guess. Playing the truck is relaxing enough. It's not a bad pastime. Price or no price, is still worth it. What's happening? Huh. Was like my accelerator was no longer working. Now it's working again. Another 100 kilometers. Oh no, I will complete this. A honk because of the tunnel. I like how it sounds. Not slowing down with all this cargo. If I slow down to accelerate again, it costs good money. You don't want to do it. Make way! We got urgent delivery for Genoa Bridge! Ok. Mm-hmm. Oh, what's up? I think I bumped the... yeah, I'm very long with these metal girdles that I'm carrying. Okay, keep to the left, it says. Did they damage them? Oh, don't break! God damn it. Don't break for no reason. While I'm looking at the damage that they already had, and indeed I did more damage. That's wonderful. That's just wonderful. Okay. So are you starting again, or do you stay there forever and ever? You got the idea. Got the idea that I would just run him over if he didn't start again. God damn it, it's the second accident today. I guess distraction really kills people, huh? This game really educates you on the danger of braking suddenly in front of a tracker. Especially one with slow-ass reflexes like me. You might dislike the results. Well, it's not the matter of slow reflexes. The problem is the field of view. If I'm looking at the screen down there, I don't see the road. They just should have placed it in front. It's wrong there. It's very dangerous to have it there and distracting. It's like having a GPS to the passenger position. In fact, it's just that. It's just that. Imagine driving like that. And it's even worse because you don't have the same field of view as real life. Same reason I had the other accident, actually. I don't even need to accelerate now to reach the speed limit, which unfortunately is enforced. Oh, wait a sec. What's going on here? We got a detour. This is the guy that I almost killed. Do I really have to take the detour, like I did last time? Because I took ages. I think I can go straight. This is the closed bridge, basically, but I am delivering to the closed bridge, no? So why shouldn't I go straight? Hey, James, hello, is this a tracking? It looks like cinema mode. Hey, it's James, hello. Or something. I'm using Vorpex, actually, yes, for this event. Because the special event for the Genoa Bridge, basically, is not in the VR version of the game. So yes, I'm projecting the game on a maxi screen with that tracking. This is the idea, more or less. Was the only way to play the event, otherwise I would have had to wait. And since I wanted to take part. And now, here we are. I was gonna ask you, how is your SnowRunner setup for VR? I had another go at it, but all I can get from Vorpex is, well, I think it's called Cinema Mode. Ah, yes, it's like this, look. You press Del. You press Del on the keyboard, and you open the overlay with all the options. Dove si va per cercare lavoro in Genova, Paki? Ah, Paki, te l'ho detto! Te l'ho detto, Paki, devi andare, guarda, te lo faccio vedere di nuovo. Non mai sentito. Se tu guardi nelle opzioni, quassù, progresso. Eccolo qui. Sono i lavori di queste due aziende in queste città, Torino, Milano, Verona, Suzzarra, Parma, Bologna, Firenze e Livorno. Eccoli qui. Cinema Mod è questo... Is this one? Wait, I'm speaking to you in Italian, James. Cinema Mod is... So you bought Vorpex to play SnowRunner? Really, man? We gotta play it together. I've been playing it a lot. It's a very cool game. I no longer do it with the wheel, unfortunately, because to... Swap the pedals every time is incredibly annoying. So, the mod you selected here. Here you have it. Cinema mod is what you have now, I think. It's this. It kind of sucks, really. You have full VR mod, but it never works. It just makes you super nauseous. And immersive screen mod is what I use. Basically, a maxi screen. You can put it very close to your face. And then you increase the FOV in the game. And the result is pretty good, James. Ah, nei lavori, ok, allora te lo spiego, Paki, così. Sono lavori esterni, offerte di lavoro, contratto esterno, e poi lo devi cercare, sono questi qua. Quelli della CDE SRL, che vengono a Genova, ovviamente. E ce ne sono due, CDS, DRL, West ed Ovest, voglio dire Ovest ed Est, e beh, praticamente li devi fare entrambi, 5-5. E quando lo fai, ti fa vedere la costruzione del ponte. Look at this, guys. We're actually building the new Genoa Bridge. It's pretty interesting, isn't it? Starting to take form. Guys, I'm kinda motivated now. A friend of mine tried Star Citizen and got head tracking to work by using OpenTrack. It emulates TrackUI. I guess it's possible to play Star Citizen in VorPex. Honestly, I never tried. I only tried the game briefly when they released the free trial and then never again. Honestly, I like Elite Dangerous way more. And that's why, to tell you the truth. Eventually, I might want to try again. There's a lot of games that work well with this method. SnowRunner is one of them. With SnowRunner, it works very well. I would say this is another one. And you can set your FOV, is the big point where it becomes enjoyable. I mean, if you can increase your FOV, then it's going to work very well. Parigi, Tolosa, Linz, Francofort. Of course, I won't be able to get a job for Genoa from Genoa. I will have to go somewhere else and then find. But I will go straight to it, not like I did last time. Otherwise, I won't be able to do it fast enough, sadly. This is just the truth. 10 jobs you gotta do, and I've done only two. So, the closest cities are Torino, Milano. Livorno. Let's try to go to Livorno. Does it tell you how long it is? Livorno is 400 kilometers. No, then it's too far. Milano, 345. Torino. Ah, Torino is the closest one, 135 kilometers. Let's go to Torino then. I think I saw you in BOS a few days ago. Performance is way better. It's wonderful. Wonderful. I love it. Now it's like 80 frames per second after I get away from the FED. Yes. I love it. In fact, I should play it more. I might play it more one of these days. I'm kinda demotivated now, James, because you might have noticed, maybe you see it by the low numbers of viewers. Unfortunately, I got banned from group sharing. In fact, I've been streaming a bit less. I should be able to share on groups again on Saturday. They gave me a 3 days ban, apparently because I share too much or something. Ah, you ordered the index. That's great news, man. Nice. We gotta play together again. It was fun. It was fun. Despite the different views on some minor matters, I guess. But we got over them very well, and we could play again. Anytime. BOS, sure, why not? It's harder without 3D Migodo, though, huh? I think they improved the spotting a bit. In fact, it is now very possible to spot things at a distance. But it's still annoying that you cannot identify things easily without 3D Migodo. That's the thing. Ok,
Inizia a
driving to
destra,
Torino
poi
now
uscire.
super fast. Let's hope I can find another job easily. Maybe I could even squeeze another one before the end of the stream.
Uscire a destra.
It will be like 3 7 weeks. I know. It's been like that ever since this thing came out. From the very first day it was like that. I had to wait even 2 months, I think. And I was on the first wave. I ordered it like seconds after it went on sale. And it was kind of an experience because when it went on sale, Steam was having some problems with the credit card payment. In fact, my payment didn't go through. I had to call the credit card company as quickly as possible and remain at the phone until the payment went through. Otherwise, I wouldn't have been able to get the thing. Let me see. I got the Yak 9. I got the Yak 9, it will be 2 kills in 2 flights. But as Stuka shut down, disconnected. I know. They do it. They do it all the time, unfortunately. No, I didn't get many kills, to tell you the truth, ever since the new update. I must have got 2 in all. For me to play without 3D Migodo is just very difficult. I started to suck recently, that's the reason I stopped playing it a bit. Another good thing is that DCS works well for me now again. In fact, I had a couple of very good sessions with DCS. It was fun, it was fun. I thought of replacing BOS with DCS for the time needed until 3D Migodo comes back, but it seems like it might never come back, apparently. Now they even deleted the thread on their forum. It's become an illegal mod. How annoying. It's the most essential thing to play in VR efficiently, unfortunately. There's a waiting list now. I have to wait for them to contact me. Then I think I have to like 48 miles. Ah, it was like that. Yes, I know. It's not the first time. It used to be like that in the beginning too, the first months. Sounds like the ordering process is a bit better. Well, that's at least a relief. Used to be overly complicated and didn't work originally, but like most of the VR devices, really. So, offerte di lavoro, external account. Let's see if I can pick up one of the Genoa Bridge jobs from here. No, 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 none. Not yet, we're still too close to the city, I guess. Okay, let's keep moving through. I keep pressing the centering and then it's the handbrake instead. Not ideal. It's not really a Mini, it only resembles one very closely. When you look at it, you realize it's actually just a look-alike rather than the actual article. I should refuel. Okay, I'm going to Turin, right? It was closer, yes. When you don't have to observe the speed limit, everything works better.
Voltare a sinistra.
I'm half tempted to ignore the red light. No, that would be a bit dangerous. I think it's actually green now. I think. Let's pretend that it is. Oh no, I see the other truck is moving too. That was kind of dangerous, but luckily it went alright. Should stream one of the Metro games with Warpex or some other FPS. I know, yeah, they're not bad. I was thinking of trying Valorant as well with Warpex, but I'm afraid it might be blocked by the anti-cheating because it modifies the game's executable essentially. To put the tracking, I mean, it does something that might irritate the security software. Well, I'm not going to a place in particular. The Metro games I don't like that much, you know. I would rather play Stalker, to tell you the truth, because Metro is very plot driven, no? There's a lot of conversation and cutscenes in general. They are not aspects that I especially enjoy in games. I would go for the more action packed titles. And in fact, I think Stalker is a superior game. We have no jobs for the Bridge of Genoa. They're not making things easier for me, it seems. We're in Turin now, one of the allowed cities in theory. It's not a job that brings you to Genoa, period. Could it be that I see the company? Ah, here is one. Yes, there's a couple. This one. Get it.
Andiamo.
Ah, it's fairly close, the pickup point. But anyway, I'm not able to complete this on stream. It's far too late.
Voltare a sinistra. Prepararsi a voltare a destra. Voltare a destra. Prepararsi a voltare a destra.
Here we are. La thing is in Turin? Wow. Voltare a destra? È qui? Is it here? Apparently. Where am I supposed to pick this trailer up? I think it's hidden well. They placed it inside here. It's an excavator, the famous excavator that you need to build bridges, yes. Indeed.
Buon viaggio.
Bon voyage! I only got another 10 minutes. Can I drive 166 kilometers in 10 minutes? I don't think so. But we can start along the way. Am I like getting stuck forever and ever? What the heck am I doing? Sometimes the external view is just necessary to realize that you're an idiot. What the heck was I attempting to do? I don't know.
Voltare a destra.
What the heck are you doing? You will have to wait. You will have to wait, don't you? Make way. Make way. You will have to wait. You gotta let the big truck through.
Prepararsi a voltare a destra.
Voltare. Seen the Mighty 8 trailer? Yes, I've seen it. We gotta play that the day it releases. I buy that thing on the first day from Microprose, no less. Wow, that's freaking cool. 10 people aboard, like the real plane. That's freaking cool. Imagine doing that in Sturmovik. In Sturmovik's engine. Inside a Sturmovik battle. That would be the shit, man.
Prepararsi a voltare a destra.
Some kind of VR P-17 game. From what they said, MFL might go down the route of Bomber Crew, whacking things with a virtual wrench to fix things. Well, but that's more or less the way of all co-op games in general, where you're on a big vehicles, no? From what I've seen, the big pirate game that now came to Steam as well, what's his name, is the same thing. The big pirate game from Microsoft, you have the various people doing the same things again and again. There are some vehicle missions in Monster Hunter that are the same. There was one in Lost Planet 2 that was the same. It's the same. When you put a series of people inside a virtual vehicle, most of them will be whacking things at random, yes. By the way, how's Bomber Crew? I was thinking of getting it for the Switch. It's often discounted for like €2. No more than that. Is it worth it anyhow? Is it a good game? Yes, it is. That one. It just came to Steam, huh? I'm half tempted, to tell you the truth. Do you think it would work in VR? That would be cool to play in VR. But even without it, maybe. Possibly, potentially.
Tenersi a destra e poi uscire a destra.
Keep to the right. And then exit to the right.
Uscire a destra.
I gotta increase my tracking a bit because I cannot see the right rear view mirror. I lower it because it was giving me some nausea, but it's just too low like this. Let's bring it to 45, I guess. No, this is too much. Maybe 40. You see, Vortex is pretty customizable.
Tenersi a sinistra.
Why would you need an excavator to build a bridge? Maybe in the initial phases when you're building the pylons, but once you're done with that. Oh, I didn't refuel. Would the fuel be enough? Possibly, possibly. 126 kilometers. 7 minutes left in the stream. I might be able to do it. If I could go over the speed limit, I certainly would. But alas, it's World of Truckers objective, so you're restricted in speed. Night is falling too. We don't go to Ravenholm at night time, right? So good thing we're actually going to Genoa and not Ravenholm. ISO is an actual fuel company from Italy because I installed the mod with the real companies, and I think ISO is the owner of the fuel station that is close to my house, if I well remember. Don't remember this tiger logo thing from their advertisement. Honestly, that might have been invented from the mod author. Zurich is also a real company. That's the Z from Zurich, I think. What is it? No, something else. Zandbergen, don't know it. Might be a German delivery company, I guess. I think I'll make it. I think I'll make it because now I'm making big progress. Going pretty fast on the roadway. Nothing stopping me now from achieving the third mission of the Genoa Bridge construction.
Tenersi a destra e poi uscire a destra. Uscire a destra.
I think now it's 1-1, yeah, a tracking is. This way it feels almost like a VR game. Unfortunately, it's still not as accurate. It's still like setting up a net tracking device. So getting it right in a way that prevents nausea completely is not as simple as one might think.
Tenersi a destra.
Oh, I was looking at the GPS. These road signs without anything written on them are kind of ridiculous. Might be some mod mistake, some error with the mods that I installed, I don't know. Come on, we will make it. Hey, you drive straight here. I made a mistake earlier. Actually, I'm already past the point. Okay. Delivery is to the right this time, it seems. And done, I guess.
Tutto è pronto. Possiamo partire.
Starting to take shape. The new bridge will be amazing, and I'm being a part of it in a way. It's a nice fantasy, I guess, a nice prospect, a nice way to build something in the context of a game. It's kind of connected to the real world as well. 53,000 experience, okay. Not worth much, unfortunately, because they're fairly short missions. So I completed two missions for West Depot, one for Miss Depot, but it's even worse than I imagined. I gotta complete six each, not just five. I'll never complete them in time. I never completed in time because they don't even give you a time span for the event, no? It's just something that other people might complete before time, before you have the chance to actually get the prize. So you either play this game only for hours on end, or you just don't get the prize, unfortunately. It's my experience with this type of events. But still, it was interesting. I'll try to take the prize. Starting to think it might be difficult. So, having come to the end of the stream, as always, I thank the few people that watched. And, well, luckily, we only have another day of ban, no? Until the ban is lifted. Yeah, tomorrow is Friday. Anyway, tomorrow I might be unable to play for other reasons. And Saturday the ban is lifted, so it's not that bad. Now, the only problem is, since Facebook didn't tell me the reason of the ban, if I get banned again. But then again, if I get banned again, and let me repeat the words several times, that might be the end of me streaming, because after all, why even struggle? You like my new wallpaper? It goes with the mood, I guess. Why even stream at that point, if apparently it's forbidden to share it. So, bye guys, thanks for all the interactions. Thank you, James, for saying hello. Hey, you got a new photo, look at that. That's a funny diary page you got with the graffiti down there. Ok, Paki, non mi fa vedere le missioni, oppure sono collegate col mio account a World of Trucks. Non so che dirti, ma la vedi la missione quando vai nel menu? Ti dovrebbe scrivere la missione sopra, se non ti scrive quella quella striscetta, il trafiletto che ti spiega cosa fare, ti compare? Perché può darsi che tu c'hai la versione vecchia del gioco installata per giocare in multiplayer, non può essere quello? E quindi devi mettere l'ultima, se no non ce l'hai l'evento. Così, una possibilità. Purtroppo ti devo salutare, sei arrivato proprio alla fine. In realtà sto già in ritardo. Però ci vediamo domani, Paghi. E se vuoi, ma penso domani potremmo anche fare SnowRunner, se riesco a streamare. Ok, ciao ciao. Bye guys. Se c'è la stringa, segui le istruzioni della stringa. Hai visto? C'è il logo della compagnia. Sono le missioni esterne. Devi andare in una di quelle città e trovarle. Ma non tutte le città ce l'hanno, eh? Non tutte. Io ho dovuto girare un po' per trovarle. Ma comunque ci va una vita. Secondo me sono 6-7 ore per completarlo tutto. E probabilmente c'è tempo fino tipo a dopodomani. Per cui mica è tanto facile. Vedi un po' te. Vedi un po' te. Poi mi racconti. Ciao ciao. Bye guys. See you tomorrow.